Today we will do test discussion. The test which I gave you previously, some of the students gave extraordinary performance, but some even do not manage to get the passing marks. So let's start the common problems which most of the student faces. First question, multiply 5 by 8 by the reciprocal of minus 3 by 8. So what is the reciprocal of minus 3 by 8? Reciprocal of minus 3 by 8 equal to minus 8 by 3. So this is the reciprocal of minus 3 by 8. Now multiply this reciprocal by 5 by 8. So 5 by 8 multiply minus 8 by 3. So answer is minus 5 by 3. Okay. Now second question. Find 5 rational numbers between 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. We have to find 5 rational numbers between 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. So first of all, make the denominators equal. So how we are going to do this? How we are going to make the denominators equal? Just take 2 and 3's LCM, which is 6, and try to make 6 in the denominator. When I try to make 6 in the denominator, then what I have to multiply with 2? Obviously 3. So I do it and multiply it also by numerator, because then, only then it will be balanced. So in the second one, I have to multiply denominator by 2 to make it 6, and then again multiply it by 2 on numerator. So now I get 3 upon 6 and 2 upon 6. Again, I do not find 5 rational numbers between them. They only have the gap of 1. So if I have to find 5 rational numbers, then I can multiply it by 2, 3, 4, whatever number I can choose. But I told you earlier that if there is certain number to multiply it, if there is some number of rational numbers which we have to find out, then we have to multiply or divide it by two more numbers. Okay, why is that? Because we do not have much time in the examination to find out by which number we have to multiply it. So multiply it, the idea is multiply it with the largest numbers, possible largest number, so that we can get the good result. So multiply it by, because in the question they give us, we have to find 5 rational numbers. Now we multiply it by 7. So multiply and divide it by 7. Maybe it can also be done by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It doesn't matter. But this is also possible. It cannot be obtained by multiplying by 2, 3. So we have to find out by hit and trial method. So this is the wastage of time. So that is why I told you, multiply and divide by 7. And you will get your 5 rational numbers between 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. Clear? Iske aage bahut easy hai, you can do it. Question number 3. Write the additive inverse. Now additive inverse, I don't think ke kisi aisa bachcha hoga jisko additive inverse nahi aata hoga. Now fourth question. Write any 5 rational numbers between minus 5 by 6 and 7 by 8. Again, we have to make equal. What we have to make equal? denominators. So how we are going to do this? Take LCM of the denominators. What denominators we have? 6 and 8. So what we get? We get 24. So 24 is the LCM. Now try to make 24 in the denominator. So what we have to multiply by 6? 4, of course. And multiply 4 on the denominator as well. So we call it multiply and division. Now again, what we have to multiply by 8 to get here 24? 3. Now multiply 3 to numerator as well. What we get? We get minus 20 upon 24, and here we get 21 upon 24. So we can easily find the 5 rational numbers, because first one is in a negative form and second one is in positive form. So let's say there is a number line 0, and here we have 20 by 24, and here we have 21 by 24. We can have 5 numbers very easily here. So minus 19 by 24, minus 18 by 24, minus 17 by 24, minus 16 by 24, minus 15 by 24. So these are the 5 rational numbers between minus 5 by 6 and 7 by 8. You can have some other numbers also, because we have lots of numbers. 0 is also in between this. Next, fifth question. Identify the rational numbers which is different. I think question dusre ho gaye na. Oh, so sorry. This one. Let's start. Question number 1. 5 rational numbers between 3 by 4 and 5 by 4. So 5 rational numbers, how are we going to find 5 rational numbers between this? First of all, we check whether the denominators are equal or not. Yes, the denominators are equal, 4 and 4. How are we going to do this? Multiply it by some number. Multiply but any number, let's say I multiply it by 4, 5, 6, 7. If you multiply it by 7, then you definitely get the best answer. But if you multiply it by some random number also, then you can also get some answer. So let's say I multiply it by 7. I get answer. Okay. Now second question. Express as fraction. हमको इसको fraction में express करना है. 1.36, 1.36, 36, dot dot dot. That means we have to express this in the form of p by q. How we are going to do this? First of all, we check how many decimals are repeated. There are two decimal places which are repeated. So this is fixed that we have to multiply it by 100. The second one thing which we have to check is that, is this in the same format by which we multiply or do some calculations? No, this is not in the same format. So let's make it in the same format. How? 1.36363636... equals to 1 plus 0.36363636. We can write it like this. Yes, of course we can write it like this. Now this one, take this one. This is in the same format. Now let x equals to 0.363636... multiply x by 100, okay? So we get 100x. Why we are going to multiply it by 100? Because we have repeated two digit numbers. So this is equals to 36.363636... 100x equals to 36 plus 0.363636. Now this one is equals to x, so put it over there. 100x equals to 36 plus x. X goes to there on the left hand side, and 100x minus x equals to 36. We got 99x equals to 36. 99 into x, so it will become x equals to 36 upon 99. It will change into division. So this is the respective value of x. Now put this value of x in where we let it. So where we let it? We let it over there. So this is our x, and we have to find this one. So put the value of x there. So we get 1.363636 plus 1, equals to 1 plus x. Now 1 plus 36 upon 99, because our x value is this, and 0.363636, we place x on this, on the place of 0.363636. So this is what we get. Take LCM, we got 99, again we got 99, and we got 36. So 36 plus 99, we got 135. So 135 upon 99. How many students got the correct answer? Message me, those who get correct answer. Next question, question number 3. Express 0.432332 in P by Q form. P by Q form, इसको express करना है. First of all, we have to check. What we check is this. First of all, we have to check whether how many decimal places are repeated. So how many decimal places are repeated? There are two decimal places repeated, so we have to multiply it by 100. And the second one is whether this is in the same format where we perform some operations. No, this is not in the same format. Why? Because 4 is over there. If the point is there and 4 is not present there, then this one will be in the same format. So how to do this? Let's see. 0.432332 will equals to 0.4 plus 0.0323232. Is this equal? This one is equals to this one? Any problem in this? No, there is no problem. So now we do not have problem with this one, because this section of number do not have bar over it, but this one is repeated. So change this one. Still this is not in the same format. Make it in the same format. How? Let's see. 0.4 can be written as 4 upon 10, and this one also we can write it like this. If point travels from there to there, from here to there, then we get 0.323232 upon 10. Is that clear? Because point travels one digit, so we take 10 in the denominator, like this only. Now, the numerator of second fraction, this one, is in the same format which we use. Okay, and this have bar also repeated. So let's take x equals to 0.323232... Now multiply x by 100. So we get 100x equals to 32.323232... So 100x equals to 32 plus 0.323232... 32 plus this one is equals to x. 32 plus x equals to 100x. X comes in the left hand side and became negative. So minus x equals to 32. We get 99x equals to 32. X equals to 32 upon 99. So this is the value x of x. Put this value of x over there, because this one we treat this one as x. Now plot this, so we get 4 upon 10 plus 32 upon 99 multiplied by 10. Is there any problem? No, there is no problem. 10 is present previously, and on the place of x we write 32 by 99. So how this will be converted? We got 4 by 10 plus 32 upon 990. Take LCM of 10 and 990. We get 990. Okay, you can take the LCM. We get 990. Now multiply this 990 by 10, divide this 990 by 10, we get 99. Now multiply that 99 by 4, we get 396 plus. Now divide this 990 by 990, we get 1. Multiply that 1 by 32, we get 32. So we got this one. You can divide it by 2 and get the final answer. And tell me how many students do this like this. Next question, fourth question, simplify those. Simplifications, first question is easy, second question is also easy, you have to multiply it in, and let's say third question. So fourth question's third part, that is C. So root 3 plus root 11 whole square, root 3 minus root 11 whole square. First, what we check? We check whether this one is similar. Yes, they are equal. 11, 11 similar. Yes, they are equal. We have plus sign, we have minus sign, equal. Perfect. Perfect for formula a square minus b square. But there is one complication. What's the complication? We have square over there. But in formula, we do not have that square. So how we are going to tackle this? Let's see. This one. A plus b whole square, we can write it like this. Even we have formula for this one, but we do not apply formula, because if we apply that formula, it makes things more complicable. So root 3 plus root 11, root 3 plus root 11, we can write this one only like this, because it has square over it. And whenever we have square over some number, we can write it like twice, this one. Okay, now again this one, we can write this also, root 3 minus root 11 into root 3 minus root 11. So multiply, 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 this will be our question. Now this has plus sign, this has minus sign, this has plus sign, this has minus sign. Combine them. root 3 plus root 11. Now this one, root 3 minus root 11. Now take this one, root 3 plus root 11. Now take this one, root 3 minus root 11. Okay. So this is nothing but the formula a square minus b square. Put the formula where a is root 3 and b is root 11. So a square minus b square. Here also a square minus b square. And you know the formula. Let me write it. A square minus b square equals to kiske barabar hota hai? A plus b and a minus b. Okay. So we have that one and we convert it into this one. This one. Now root 3 square, that means 3 minus root 11 square, that means 11. And here we have root 3, so 3 minus 11 also there. So 11 minus 3, we get 8 negative, and also here we get negative 8. So 8 is 64, and minus minus plus, so 64 is the answer after simplification. How many students do it correctly? Give me a copy. Okay. And all must have to do correction work. Okay. Next one, rationalization. Rationalization, fifth question, A part. 2 upon root 3 minus 1. So how are we going to rationalize this? Multiply it by root 3 plus 1, root 3 plus 1. So what we get? We get 2 root 3 plus 2, and here we have formula. So root 3 square minus 1 square. That formula which we already done in the previous question. So we get 2 root 3 plus 2 upon 3 minus 1. So we get 2 root 3 plus 2 upon 2, 3 minus 1, that is 2. Now take 2 common from this one, from the new data. So we get 2 root 3 plus 1 upon 2. 2 to cancel out, we get root 3 plus 1. How many students do this correctly? Give me the copy, okay? Question number 5, B part. 7 root 12 minus root 5. This one is same question as we done before, except the common part. So I'm not going to do this. If anybody has any type of error in this, you can ask me later on WhatsApp. So C, 1 upon 8 plus 3 root 5. So this is very simple. Multiply and divide by 3 root 5, 8 minus 3 root 5. So we get 8 minus 3 root 5 upon 8 square minus 3 root 5 whole square. So again we have formula. So this is formula and we write it like this. So we get 8 minus 3 root 5 and 64 minus 3 multiply, sorry, 9. 9 multiply 5. Why 9 multiply 5? Because we have root 5 over there. Square root cancel out. And we have 3 also. So 3 will become 9. So 9 multiply by 5, which is 95. Sorry, 45. 8 minus root 5, 64 minus 45. You can solve this. Sixth and the last question. How many students do this properly? 7 to 9, 1 upon 6. So 729. Take LCM of 729. This is the multiple of 3. So you can check it by divisibility rule. So 3 to the 6, 12, 9. Again 3. What? 24. Again 3. So how many 3 we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 3. That means 3 raised to the power 6. We can write 729 like 3 raised to the power 6. So 3 raised to the power 6 and whole raised to the power 1 by 6. Now according to the formula, multiply 6 by 1 by 6, we get 3, 6 multiply 1 by 6. This is in the rough work. Okay. So 6 upon 6, which got cancelled out, we get 1. So 1. So that means 3 is the answer. Okay. Now the next one, B. 64 and power 2 by 3. Take LCM of 64. You got 2 raised to the power 6. So we get 2 raised to the power 6 and whole raised to the power 2 by 3. Multiply 6 into 2 by 3. What we get? 3 1 3 3 2 6. We get 4. So 2 raised to the power 4. What is 2 raised to the power 4? What is 2 raised to the power 16? So 16 is the answer. Okay. 2 raised to the power 4 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. That is 16. 4 times. Now final question, let me check the time. We have 2 minutes left, guys. Let's make it fast. So 81, 1 by 3 upon 81, 1 by 12, okay. So 81 is nothing but the factor, but the multiple of 3. So 81 is the multiple of 3, so 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, we get 4 times 3. So 3 raised to the power 4 and whole raised to the power 1 by 3. And here also we get 3 raised to the power 4 and whole raised to the power 1 by 12. Multiply this, we get 3 raised to the power 4 by 3 and 3 raised to the power 4 by 12. Okay. Now, if something, yes, 4 and 12, these got cancelled out, we get 3 raised to the power 4 by 3 and 4 1s are 4, 4 3s are 12. So, 3 raised to the power 1 by 3. Okay. Now these are in the division and the base is same, the powers will become subtract. So 3, 4 by 3 minus 1 by 3, we get 3 raised to the power 4 minus 1, 3, 3 upon 3, which again get cancelled out further. So 3 raised to the power 1, that is 3. So 3 is the answer. Okay. You have to do all these correction work and send it to me back. Okay, our test discussion is completed.